area might fall. So Dr. Hollinger each year likes to look at not just where things have been, but where we're headed. We know the ball is here right now in front of us, but where is it going to be two or three plays away? So the next slides reflect what you have all said you will do more of in this year and years to come. So where you're going. I think it's a great idea, and it certainly gives you the opportunity as you see some of these things, take them back and action them, of course, and know where your friends and colleagues are putting their emphasis. But you're here in what is the industry event, and you have an expo hall full of service providers to look at. So just keep that in mind, and perhaps that might give you a booth or two to consider when you're walking the show floor later today. So let's get on with it. And when we look at integrity screening, top of the list here, criminal conviction checks. With technology today and criminal conviction checks, gone are the days of going down to the courthouse on every single case and trying to figure out, if there's a criminal record, and then figuring out the prior jurisdictions and making phone calls and calling in all sorts of favors. Today, you're entering that data in electronically, covering multiple jurisdictions and databases that are far more robust, and you're getting the information back in near real time. This is no longer the 7 to 10 day process for almost every pre-employment or post-employment check that you're doing. It now comes back in near real time or within just a day or two. And that, of course, might alter how you focus. Do you do pre-employment on store-level associates, or do you do post-employment or a blend of both? But the next two categories on here were really interesting when I got to thinking about it. And the first was multiple interviews, right? So soft costs, times that you're investing in interviewing a candidate over and over again. And the next one being pre-employment verification, so picking up the phone and doing those checks on where they've been, and you might ask reasons for leaving, you might not get it, but what this indicates is that you've been doing more, and you will continue to do more of these. Now, what's interesting on both of them is that they're soft costs. So you're not necessarily going out and hiring a third party to do them. You're absorbing that internally with your department, HR, operators, and you're pushing more. And the reason that's fascinating is when you flip to our next slide, which is awareness programs, the top two categories that we're focused on. Where people are headed, more lectures and periodic programs. Lectures that you give, I'm sure. Again, soft costs. And then orientation discussions. So new hire orientation discussions, again, soft costs. So that was sort of an interesting relation there that I thought I would point out. But, of course, on this list, all the other programs you would fully expect. Internet training, CD-ROM training, hotlines, bulletin board posters. I mean, all really, I think, staple, baseline stuff that we've been doing. And perhaps changing, the posters of today are going to be the flat screens of tomorrow, flashing, up-to-date statistics and, high-ranking offenders or praise for, district or regional accelerated performance. When we look at asset control policies or asset control programs, on this list, and I don't think we've had a year where POS exception-based reporting wasn't number one or certainly high on the list. I mean, guys, is there anybody in the room that doesn't do POS exception reporting today? If you don't, I mean, come out of the rock. Welcome to the party. I mean, I think everybody, in one way or another, we're all doing POS exception-based reporting. But where we've seen things go over the last few years, especially as our databases are more integrated and we're working on these gigantic platforms that shuffle data, everything from the merchant systems to POS, the human resources, even to some shipping and receiving and other divisional or related entities, we're starting to see exception-based reporting become more comprehensive. So think about that as you're looking at where the program goes next. Next on the list here, refund controls, a topic near and dear to my heart. Over the last 5 years, as the NRF has done its refund fraud survey each year, we've really seen these numbers shift. 5 years ago, it was all about clamping down on the controls. How do we really cut back on refund abuse through requiring receipts and shortening up that period of or window, you know, from a 90-day to a 60-day or a 90-day to a 30-day period on refund controls. And then in 2008, we started to see those controls sort of slip because, as Rosa Maria Cecilio would put it from Saks, it was about developing this, you know, this intimate relationship with the customer and giving them the confidence that they can shop today and bring the items back tomorrow. But where we've seen these things sort of flow both directions, refund controls remain critical to the operation. Everybody is sort of right-sizing how they work within your organization and with your customer and product type. Some tightening it down a little bit, others loosening it up, especially around the holidays. But it was interesting that this ranks so high at over 20%. For where you're headed, where your mind's at in terms of things you're going to look at this year. In LP systems, cameras, CCTV, category killer here across the board. Everybody, 20% or more, most in a quarter or more, said that CCTV is a focus. I think ding dong, the witch is gone. VCRs, for the few that are out there, their days are probably getting numbered. Everybody is switching to digital recording, IP-based cameras, and camera systems are really starting to do a number of things. I mean, exciting stuff. Everything from people counting to doing merchandise audits, store audits, LP audits. You're able now to dial into a store, dial in. We still use dial in. I think AOL, dialing in. You're able to log on into a store and in real time watch everything that's happening, your staffing levels and line breaks, etc. So CCTV, the big category killer here. And then also notice that connected to POS. So how do we connect the POS data and put it side by side against what we're seeing on what could be POS exception-based reporting information? So some interesting things there. For key facts, I thought I'd thrown a lot at you in 15, 16 minutes now. So I wanted to give you just, if you're taking notes, here are some quick notes you might want to write down on loss rates. Preliminary results show retailers the current shrink rate at 1.44% at a dollar loss of $33.49 billion, or let's call it $33.5 billion, right? If we took those numbers and looked at them against 19 years, they're the lowest. That's the lowest shrink rate we've seen in 19 years. We're actually tied with 2008 at 1.44. So hopefully this is the new baseline, and we just keep improving that number. But some key stats for you. But when you go back, and I know with the, especially when I'm doing meetings now around the country, I try and find ways of breaking the data up a little bit. So how do we get people to really care about this and give it to them in bite sizes? So in the course of today, we're going to lose $91.8 million today across the industry. By the end of this session, by the end of the awards program, which follows this presentation, we're going to lose $3.8 million in just the hour today. And every hour today we're here. So that's a number you take back, and for the law enforcement partners in the room, this merchandise shrinkage represents lost tax revenue, because that $33.5 billion, nobody's paying the sales tax on it, and in a time when we are cutting budgets and releasing prisoners in some states, nonviolent offenders, right? And nonviolent offenders, you might as well say, shoplifters and fraudsters, right? Nonviolent property crime. We have got to make sure that there is really a stick with criminals, and laws are changing, and everybody's looking at cutting the budget, but maybe these are some ways that you can articulate how we're losing across the industry.